How to use prepositions. At, on, and in. The word preposition comes from the Latin word preponere. Pre means before, and ponere means to place. So the word preposition means placed before, and this describes one of the features of prepositions. They are words placed before nouns. That is the president of Colombia. Of is our preposition, and Colombia is our noun. My brother hiked up the mountain. She is good at programming. So, prepositions are words placed before nouns, but what do? They describe relationships between ideas. Let's focus on three specific prepositions. At, on, and in. At is used to indicate a precise measurement, a specific point on a scale. We will go to the store at 3 o'clock. The plane cruised at 190 miles per hour at 4,000 feet. At is also used to indicate a point of focus, a target. There is no need to yell at me. Look at the stars. At is also used to indicate a location. I'm at work right now. Shall we meet at the hotel? There are lots of emotions we can direct at people and things. You can be annoyed, amazed, angry, astonished, shocked, and surprised at something. There are also skills and abilities which you may be good or bad at. You can be clever, brilliant, and experienced at doing something, or slow and terrible at it. Let's move on to on, which is used to indicate weight or support. I can always rely on you. The drinks are on me. On is also used to indicate an activity. I'm on my computer. You're always on your cell phone. On is used to indicate time and location. Do you live on Main Street? She will give birth on May 13th. There are different ways that you can pay attention to things. You can concentrate, focus, insist, and put emphasis on something. And finally, in, our last preposition, which is used to indicate a state of being. I'm in love. My brother is in trouble. In is also used to indicate containment. The animal was locked in its cage. You can find me in the post office. In is also used to indicate a span of time. You need to wake up in the morning. The train leaves in 10 minutes. The meanings of at, on, and in can overlap. It's difficult to know when to properly use each one. Don't be discouraged if you make a mistake. Try filling in the blanks with at, on, and in. Pause the video here. And here are the answers. I lived in an apartment in Kingston, Ontario, on James Street. It was a lovely location. Sometimes, at night, I walked to a nearby park and lay on the grass. You might also say, lay in the grass, looking up at the stars in amazement. I could see so many of them. I felt so small, like a tiny dot on Earth. Lost in my thoughts, I always lost track of time. Suddenly, I would look at my watch and realize that it was almost midnight.